Set up for those of y'all that want to know all that good stuff. All right, so the belt itself is a belt made by 21st Tactical out of Fayetteville, North Carolina. If you're ever in the Fort Bragg, Fayetteville, Cumberland County area, stop on by, give the guys a holler, and you know, probably buy something, give you some good stuff, give you some good insight, make something custom for you. Really good folks over here. The belt itself. This is the belt, all right? It's a two-stage belt system. It's an inner and it's an outer belt. I like it like that because, you know, that kind of gives you the availability to buy an inner belt. And then you can just buy two outers, like if you want to have a belt for three-gun, if you want to have a belt for your job, your occupation, or something like that. It's actually pretty cool, you know, to be able to swap without having to take all your gear off, put all your gear back on. If you got the time to do it, go ahead. But if you're lazy like me and you don't want to do that, all right, you know, just buy a second belt. Just be good to go. The belt itself is very rigid. You know, this is just holding it from one side. And, you know, holding it just like that. It's a very rigid belt. I like that. It's not as rigid as some law enforcement belts, like the big leather ones that the police officers wear. It's not as rigid as that, but it's a very rigid belt. So it kind of stands up to you hanging things off of it. You know, it's a very good load-bearing belt. Comes with a Cobra buckle with a D-ring on the front right here. D-ring's pretty cool when you're doing, like, rock climbing or something like that. Officially, the belt is not rated for poundage, but pay attention. Unofficially, it can probably hold 1,400 pounds. That's all I'm gonna say about that. But it's a very good belt. It's scuba webbing, Velcro all the way through, scuba webbing, it's 2-inch nylon, but the way they have it set up is you have a 1/2-inch Molly on the top, then you have 1-inch in the middle, then you have a 1/2-inch on the bottom. That allows you to molly your stuff there without having it stick all the way up into your rib cage if your torso is that small. Mine is, the majority of my height comes from my legs. I am not proportionate in that instance. It sucks sometimes. But there's a belt to rectify that situation. Awesome. So, go ahead and take this off here. Like so. So a whole lot of Velcro. You guys want to know how to make Velcro silent? Like how you want to not hear it? You want to not hear it? Okay, this is how you not hear the Velcro when you're taking it apart. You didn't hear the Velcro, did you? Gotcha. Anyway though. You take the belt off and you kind of run it through your belt loops here. Alright? It fits belt, normal standard size belt loops. It fits it. You probably kind of run it through there. And then you take the outer portion of the belt and just kind of wrap it around like so. All right. That's pretty much how you put the belt on. Now, into the good stuff. It's pretty much what all you guys came here for. I'm going to talk about my setup. And I want to pre-apologize right now because for the majority of the rest of this video, you're going to be staring at my junk. And possibly portions of my ass. And if you have a problem with that, well, you should, because I'm magnificent. Okay, welcome back. See what I'm saying? You're staring at my junk. Staring at my junk. Staring at my junk. And you're still staring at my junk. What is wrong with you? I'm just playing. I put that on you. My bad. Anyway, though, this is my belt setup right here. As you can see, I have it through my belt loops right there. I have the outer portion Velcro to it, and it doesn't really go anywhere, all right? Except for because I have thin waist, and so it just flows with the wind. Anyway, though, the belt itself, very, very robust. You see, I have a lot of junk hanging off of it, right? So with all this junk hanging off of my belt, it still doesn't do the whole fold over thing. So that's a testament to the belt's rigidity and its ability to actually bear some sort of loads, all right? Loads. Anyway, though. All right, so we're just going to go ahead and we're going to go in, I guess, a circle. Right here, I have a tourniquet. Now, this is my right side tourniquet. I also have one on the left side. I'll just cover both of them right here. Have a right side tourniquet and a left side tourniquet. Anytime someone needs a tourniquet on my right or my left, I just, you know, pull that down. I'm able to pull the tourniquet out, throw it to them or whatever, or, you know, put it down here like that. I kind of like the whole ambidextrous thing when it comes to getting equipment and stuff like that, because it just makes things a little bit simpler. And yeah, it's two tourniquets. Tourniquets are like 0.9 half of an ounce, so it's whatever, dude. Carry tourniquets, because the worst time you'll need a tourniquet is the time when you need a tourniquet. All right, let me go ahead and connect this one here. Don't know what I'm doing, but anyway, here we go. All right, so next to this tourniquet coming over here, I have a Safariland holster. This is a Safariland holster for a Glock 34, but because my Glock 19 is comped with the light, it fits in the Glock 34 holster, which is pretty awesome. You know, it has this nice release button right here. You know, you put it in, it doesn't come out until you hit the release button, like so, and then the gun comes out. All right, so good holster. I like it, stands up to it. Plus, it's got the nice Cordura over there. It cuts down on the IR signature. Those of you guys who know what this is, and you already know what's up, you don't need not talk about it, but it's there. High-speed gear taco mag pouch right here for my multi-tool. Now, this is actually a mag pouch for pistol magazine, but it fits the multi-tool pretty dope. They also make a longer one that can fit an ASP or a longer flashlight or something like that, and that's usually used by the police departments and things of that nature. All right, so this one is pretty cool. It works for that. You never know when you need a multi-tool. This is I think it's like a Catalyst, whatever you call it. Anyway, a knife is cool. Always carry a knife with you because you never know when you're going to need it. But my daughter bought me this knife from Walmart with like a gift card or something that she had. So for those of you guys talking nonsense about, oh, you need to get a better knife, fuck you. This knife is the greatest knife on the world. You could kiss my ass if you say otherwise. This right here is a roll-up IFAK. Okay? It's the IFAK that I use on people. So what I do is I just take those two bungee straps off, like so, and this IFAK can actually just get peeled right off, like that, all right? So you pull this tab right here, and it just comes rolling out. There's a picture of it on my social media, or at the beginning of this video of it rolled out with like some things in it and all that good stuff. So this one works great. You know, you could just rip it off, throw it to somebody with either hand. So you put it back on. You know, put it back on, you just connect it to the Velcro again, and you take your bungee straps like so, and just reconnect it. Bam, right back on it. All right, dump pouch right next to the IFAK is the dump pouch. This is another Velcro thing. 21st Tactical, this IFAK is from 21st Tactical. This dump pouch is from 21st Tactical. They make some good stuff. You just pull it down, and it unrolls like so. And it has little bungee retentions right here. You can put Kim lights, you can put shotgun shells or whatever. But for predominant use, it's a dump pouch, you know, or chalk bag holder, which I'm gonna show you in a minute. So we'll see what's up. All right, now right here, high speed gear taco combo pouches for the mag pouch for the pistol and the rifle, high speed gear taco pouches. You've seen them on my plate carrier. I love these things. They are not so big and bulky to where they just become cumbersome, but they do offer retention for my magazines, which is what I really go for. All right, so talked about that one. You already know about this one. Kind of talked about it here again. And little Magpul paraclip with some 1-inch webbing and a tri-glide to hold my gloves. All right, that's pretty much it there. All right, now you guys are probably looking at this one here. This is a climb-rated carabiner. Now, this thing serves two purposes. One purpose is I bring it around like this and clip it to the front D-ring like so. But it kind of wraps around here. What this does is if I have to go hands-on with something and I got to put my rifle to the side, I just put my rifle to the side and I wrap this around it, around the rifle, to kind of keep it stowed on this side right here. So that way it doesn't really get in the way of me doing whatever I got to do on this side in the front like so. All right, but you know, it kind of works there. Now the other reason for it, and you know, go ahead and show you, for those of you who have to do like climbing ops or land ops or whatever like that, this is a Misty Mountain Hasty harness. All right, now with the Misty Mountain Hasty harness, all you do is you just kind of step in through here like so. You kind of pull this up over all your shit like that. Grab that there. All right, and bam, you know, you got yourself a nice little hasty harness going on. So when you got to do some climbing ops or some land ops or whatever. All right, so that is the 21st tactical belt. That's about it. You guys got any questions about it, hit me up. All the social media shit and the emails coming at the end. Other than that, man, you guys have a good one, and catch you cool cats on the flip side. Peace.